Good morning, folks. We've got space, sun, and Earth news to hit today, including stories that tie back to core topics in the community. Let's begin at spaceweathernews.com and find the last day on our star was an inactive one once again in terms of sunspots, solar flares, and CMEs. Coronal holes entering Earth-facing position, and the solar wind dropped intensity a bit more. Geomagnetic conditions are exceptionally quiet, and with the KP index so low, we'll begin to monitor for zero runs and cosmic ray health alerts. Earth magnetically connected with those coronal holes overnight, we do have an uptick risk for seismic events through the weekend. Yesterday, the lithospheric news was mostly volcanic. Philippines increasing alert after volcanic quakes there, and a modest eruption in Alaska as well. Top weather events are of the cold kind, and we begin with summer almost arrived down under, and yet a snowstorm blanketed the ground. Great photos coming in from the southeast region of the country. How about some winter storms in Israel? These are more violent than cold for the most part, but the hail flash floods do still accompany them. And of course, we knew this was coming. Thanksgiving was indeed the coldest on record for much of the northeast United States, with many enduring record snows for this time of year as well. Let's begin the science at HH211. Folks, there's no better antidote to cosmological ignorance than their discoveries of massive dust and water reservoirs around stars. They are certain this is not a new feature of the system, but a primordial feature that our technology just couldn't see before. Interesting piece out of Cornell on moons, mountains, and planetary rings. While every aspect of this science says moons need to hold the rings in place, these scientists have discovered that something even like a mountain can produce the minute changes in attractive pull needed to shepherd rings into stability. We've got some nature art here. These pictures were taken from satellite of the northern Siberian Reach, where small islands jut into the Arctic Ocean and create this incredible scene. Does anyone remember the big cosmology news of 2015? Galaxies and galaxy clusters in the cosmic web are not only sitting on the filaments, on the strings, but they are equidistant apart from one another. We learned in 2017 that their disks are all oriented perpendicular or parallel based on their size class as a galaxy, and today, we find yet another excellent example of these galaxies strung out on a line. Abel 781, showing off its string of pearls in this latest release. Up next, Earth's magnetic field. We know it's changing, and we learned this year that the math works to say it could be created by Earth's oceans, maybe not the core. Well, here comes a collaboration centered at Berkeley showing how powerful magma mantle oceans can produce a planetary magnetic field as well. This does have implications for all planets of requisite size and chemical composition. The news out of the UN is describing a record high amount of plant food on Earth. What my twisted article name and actual body content don't mention is that they mean it's a record for human scientific observation. We are indeed at the right side of the paleoclimate chart. Black line is CO2, and indeed, for those who know about Earth's history, it is the high heat and high CO2 periods that are friendliest to life explosions on this rock. Last but not least, we've already seen that Venus is changing rotation and its winds are accelerating much faster in change than Earth's. The temperature shifts on Mars are dwarfing those we see on this planet. Jupiter is changing most of all with variation in radio output and numerous cloud features and storms. Saturn's rotation is slowing as well, and its Saturn annual storm broke all the rules this last time around. Coming early, was the strongest ever witnessed and refused to go away. After learning the same story on Uranus this last year, including never-before-seen auroral activity, we today get confirmation of Neptune's changes as well. Once again, strongest, largest, and most enduring system for the blue gas planet has new records on the books. Folks, it's not our pollution messing with all these planets. It's the sun. We greatly appreciate your support, and folks, Kat is in Wonka mode, putting golden coins from our first conference into 5 packages going out this weekend. Each is going to let you have some fun. Only at otf.cells.com and only this weekend. We've got your wind maps and shots of our star to close. We'll do this all again tomorrow, right here, but right now it's 4:20 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.